sprouts we all know are very healthy. So today we'll be preparing black chana sprouts in a slightly different way. So for this you need black chana sprouts. You need to soak black chana in sufficient water for overnight and then wrap it in a damp cloth, and within 1 to 2 days you will get these nice long chana sprouts. Need to saute our sprouts. For this we'll heat 1 tablespoon of oil in a kadhai, then splatter cumin seeds or zira in it. After that we'll add few chopped vegetables like onions and capsicum. We'll saute it on medium to high flame and we'll add our black chana sprouts in it. Mix everything well, and we need to cook sprouts on medium to high flame for at least 5 to 10 minutes. One can cover the pan and then allow the sprouts to cook. Once sprouts become soft, then we'll add salt, black pepper, chaat masala, and we'll also add some berries into it. You can add any berries of your choice along with nuts if you want. Mix everything well and we'll just cook it for 1 to 2 more minutes. As a last step, we'll add tomatoes and mix it once again. Keep the flame on medium to high side. And our very healthy proteinaceous black chana sprouts are ready. So it took just 10 minutes to prepare this yummy healthy snack. Another healthy and a quick munching snack is this roasted makhana peanuts. So for this we'll take salt in a kadhai. We'll be first roasting pumpkin seeds in salt. Pumpkin seeds will take only 1 minute to roast. So once it is roasted, then we'll separate seeds from salt using a sieve in this manner. And here it goes. Our pumpkin seeds are done. Then in the same kadhai, we'll be roasting makhana. So keep on stirring the makhana. Makhana will take little time. So we have to roast it till the makhana becomes crispy. And my makhana has also roasted well. You can see the color of the makhana has changed. And once you press one piece, then it will crush like this. Now we'll also separate makhana from salt in a similar manner using a sieve. To roasted makhana, we'll add roasted pumpkin seeds, and here goes roasted peanuts which we have roasted in a similar manner. Mix everything well, and this snack is not only very light and healthy, but it also helps in building immunity.
This is 1 cup of boiled chana. Simply soak chana for at least 8 to 10 hours and then boil it with little salt in water. To make these more crispy, we'll add gram flour or besan. Then we'll also add rice flour. Then we have added chopped ginger and garlic, and after that we'll add 1 tablespoon of oil, add a pinch of salt. Then we will mix all these ingredients nicely. Deep fry these chanas to make it crispy. However, I'll be using my air fryer to fry these chanas. Air fry our chanas at 180 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. These chanas are quite crispy. Now let's prepare our white chana chaat. For this, we'll add all our chopped vegetables, salt as per your taste. Then we'll add chaat masala, add fresh coriander and give it a nice toss. This is a very healthy snack recipe. You can munch on it any time of the day. Lastly, add lemon juice in it to add to the flavor. Once again, we'll mix it. Here is my very healthy power-packed chana chaat ready. We need to roast papad to make it crunchy. So I'll be sharing 2 ways of roasting papad. Firstly, we'll be applying little desi ghee on top of papad. And then we'll roast it in microwave. Then we'll microwave it at full power for 30 seconds first. Again, roast it for 30 seconds more. And just look at this, papad has roasted well. The second method to roast papad is on tawa. I've already applied desi ghee on this papad and we'll just roast it on tawa. So our papad is done. This is the one which we did in microwave and this papad is the one which we roasted on tawa. Now let's prepare our masala papad. Firstly, we'll sprinkle chopped onions on top of it. Then goes tomatoes. Do not add too much tomatoes as it will make the papad soggy. Add all the spices. Here goes salt, little red chili powder. Then we'll add chaat masala. Sprinkle lots of sev. Here goes bundi. Bundi gives more crispness to masala papad and it tastes very nice. Then add fresh coriander to give nice color. And finally sprinkle lemon juice to give final touch to our masala papad. And our light crispy starter is ready to serve. Firstly, you need to drain extra water from the corn kernels. We will add salt and black pepper. We will mix it nicely. Thereafter, we will sprinkle rice flour onto it. Rice flour will give crispness to our kernels. Once the mixing is done, we'll allow it to rest for 1 minute. Then we have to heat oil in a pan. Stirring the corns in between. It will take approximately 5 to 10 minutes for corns to get crispy. Now you can see my corns are done. The color of the corn has changed. We'll switch off the flame and we'll transfer all the corns on our tissue paper. Into the same pan, we'll heat little butter because we are now preparing the tempering for our crispy corns. To this, we will add sliced onions. We do not want our onions to get too brown. So at this stage only, we'll add sliced capsicum and little bit of soya sauce. Then add vinegar. You can further add fresh coriander into it.
Here are my crispy corn kernels ready to serve. Isn't it a very simple and a quick snack recipe?